Hi everyone, and welcome back to another video with me, Elizabeth Bishop, your Autodesk Fusion instructor. In today's video, we're going to be going through looking at different file types that we can use in Autodesk Fusion. We'll have a look at importing files and opening files, and also at how we can export different files from Autodesk Fusion. To start off with, we'll look at the native Fusion file types that we've got. So in Fusion, as a cloud-based product, we have all of our data stored in the data panel, and we can open up our native Fusion file formats from here. So the native file for a Fusion file is a .f3d file. And this is our baseline file for a Fusion file. So we can open that up from the data panel by double-clicking on it, and this will appear in our workspace here. We can also access all of our files that are saved in our cloud without going into the data panel. So if your data panel is closed, you can click File and then Open, and this brings up more of a File Explorer style menu that you might be more familiar with when using your laptop or PC. So from here, you can explore your different file locations and you can open up the file that you wish to do so there. Now in this case, I've already got this file open, so it doesn't do anything extra. You may have also seen from that same menu, we can open from My Computer. So if you have the file not already saved in Fusion, you can click Open from My Computer, and then you can click one of your files in here and click Open. And this, as an F3D file, has now opened here. You'll see that this isn't saved in my data panel at this point. So what I can do is click Save, and that would then save this into the data panel, and this would be in the cloud saved location in my Autodesk Fusion account. Another way that we could do this, I'm just going to close that and delete it to show you, is by clicking the Upload button here. So this time, click Select Files. This again opens up my File Explorer on my laptop or PC. I can select that housing and click Open. We can then upload that into the data panel. This is a great way for using files that someone else has sent to you if you're not using a Fusion Teams. If you're interested in how to use Fusion Teams, please check out this video here. So that's our basic .f3d file, our native file for Autodesk Fusion. There is another type of file that you might come across which is native to Fusion, and this is a .f3z file. And this is when we have a linked component in an assembly file. So this here that I've got on the screen now is an assembly file, but all of the data for it is saved within this one Fusion file that I have here. Someone else might have been working on a file that has linked components, and when you have a linked component, there will be a small linked symbol against a component. Now, if you're sent one of those files, it'll come up as a .f3z. So I'll upload one of those now to show you what that looks like. So this one here, I'm going to click Open, and we can see that the file type here is F3Z instead of F3D. And again, you can change the location you want to add this to if you'd like to here. I'm going to add it to the same folder as I've added the others, and I can click Upload there. We'll see that we get a notification to say our upload has started, and that it may take several minutes to complete. If you need to check on the status of an upload, you can click on this button here, and it will tell you what's going on in terms of your job status. And once that's complete, we can view them in our data panel. You'll see here that this time it's uploaded two files. If we click on the engine assembly file and open that one, you'll see here that linked component, and that linked component there is this second cylinder here in our file formats there. So that's just one to be aware of there. One of the great things about using these native Fusion file formats is that it contains all of the design history for that particular file. So if we can see here for the simple gearbox, it contains all of the design history used to create the components in this assembly here. There's actually a whole host of supported file formats that Autodesk Fusion can open. I'm going to show you a few of them now, but if you need to check any file formats, you can do so at this link here. We're now going to have a look at some mesh file types that Autodesk Fusion can open. We'll have a look at the STL file, the OBJ file, and the 3MF file. Now, if you're interested, in learning how to manipulate and import meshes further, you can check out this video here. But there's two different ways we can insert that mesh into Autodesk Fusion. The first way we can do that is using the insert and insert mesh. And that's what that video will show you how to do and all the different settings in there. The other way we can do this is from our data panel. Using the same method that we've uploaded our other files with, we can press upload here. I'm going to select three different files to upload and show you the differences with them. So clicking on my select files, or if you already have your file explorer open, you can drag and drop them here. So I'm going to select three different file types here, a 3MF file, an STL file, and an OBJ file. And we'll click upload to add those to the data panel. You can see here the type it lists as 3MF, STL, and OBJ. And we can click upload there. An STL file, or stereolithography file, is an interchangeable file format that houses universal 3D formats focused solely on the surface geometry and the shape. They don't typically contain any colours, textures, or attributes. It's that very basic tessellated mesh surface that we showed in those other videos. They're really good for quick prototyping, 3D printing, and some CAM software applications. However, they only contain that simple data and thus only work well in those simple situations. So that STL file that I uploaded there is the cylinder head. So opening that, you can see that it's a tessellated version of the cylinder head from that engine assembly. And we don't have any of our design history here. Looking at the component, it's just that single component with one body showing that mesh style body there. And as I said, we can manipulate that using the mesh tools here. In comparison, we have something called a 3MF file. Now, this is really good for if you have multiple different bodies or components in that file. So you can see here in the browser, the component list contains all of these different components. Now, this file here is one that's been made for 3D printing in multiple colors. So the different bodies can be selected to set those different colors. 3MF files contain further data to an STL, and they can contain information about, for example, a 3D printing setup. The final file that I uploaded there, the final mesh one, was a OBJ file. Now, an OBJ file is, again, a universal text-based 3D model format, but it can house references to one or more MTL files, which can contain additional surface shading data. In this case, this OBJ file doesn't contain that data, but it is possible to link those if you contain all of the other surface data within the file that you upload. One downside to an OBJ file is the file size. They are much bigger than those STL files, but you can still manipulate them in the same way as you can with all those other mesh tools. The difference between uploading a file into your data panel versus inserting it is that when you upload it, it's then saved in your cloud data compared to when you insert a mesh. For example, if I insert a mesh using this tool here from my computer and insert the cactus coaster again, you'll see here it's much quicker to insert using the insert tool, but it is not saved in my data panel and I would need to save that file if I wanted to do so. So I could save that file and you'll see that it'll appear in my data panel. Once you've uploaded a mesh file like this, you'll notice that there's no design history. This means that a number of the tools are not available to us to use in Fusion. However, we can turn on our design history to utilize those tools going forward. So by right-clicking on that top level component, you can click Capture Design History. Whilst this doesn't add any design history for any previous operations, it does mean that any edits you make down the line will be captured in that design history. So that's some quick ways that you can work with mesh files in Autodesk Fusion. Mesh files are really great for prototyping, 3D printing, and that kind of work. And it's great when you need to manipulate something that you only have that mesh file for. As I mentioned earlier, Autodesk Fusion is able to open a vast range of files. One of these is the stepfile.step, which is the standard for the exchange of product data. Step files are among the most acceptable CAD formats and are an ISO standard across several industries. The ISO standard is 10303-2XX, and the XX determines which of those step file formats that are available. And there are three major mechanical step file formats. A step file contains three-dimensional models saved in a plain text format, and it is readable by Autodesk Fusion. The text describes the model structure, and it's written in an ASCII format that adheres to those aforementioned ISO standards. In order to open a step file, we can use that same method and upload it to our data panel. I'm going to upload a step file version of that engine assembly file. And you can see here, again, we've got that type, and that's a step file. So we can click upload and wait for that to upload to our data panel. Step files might be a little larger than some of your other files and may take a little longer to upload. You can always check that upload status using the button down here. And once it's done, it will give you a notification to say it's uploaded. Opening up this step file, we can see that it contains a lot more data and information than those mesh files. We have all of our components inside here, and we can see that each of those components contains that data. The model is also able to be manipulated in our model workspace. However, we do not have that design history down at the bottom. In comparison, just opening up the previous F3Z file that I uploaded, you can see the difference here with that design history down at the bottom. However, going forward with this file, if I wanted to make edits, I can turn on that design history by right-clicking on the top-level component and clicking Capture Design History. This means that whilst we just have these components here, any edits I make going forward, for example, if I want to make an edit to this comrod, I can activate the comrod, add a fillet to this edge here, say of 1 millimeter, and this fillet will appear in our design history here. And we can see when we activate the top level component, the fillet is there, and that fillet is showing in our design history here. Step files are great for if you need to transfer data across different CAD platforms and need something that can be read universally. As well as the native Fusion files, Fusion can also open up other files from the Autodesk suite, including Inventor files. To do this, we use the same method. We can go to upload in our data panel, and we can drag and drop that file in here, and we've got that IPT. This is an Inventor part file, and we can click upload to add that into Fusion. You can check the status of that using your upload progress button here. And once complete, you can close that and open up the Inventor file. You can see here we've got a stepper motor that was designed in Inventor. As this is a single part, there's no extra components. We just have the number of bodies used in this file. We also have no design history in this part here, again restricting the tools that we can use in Fusion. You can, of course, turn on that design history by right-clicking and capturing design history. Any edits we make now will be captured down the line. As you've seen, Autodesk Fusion can not only open other file formats from the Autodesk suite, but it can also open files from other CAD packages, for example, Solidworks parts. In order to do this, you will need to use the upload button in your data panel. So Fusion can open the native SLDPRT file, which is the Solidworks part file. So selecting that there, we can click upload, and this will add it into our data panel. These uploads may take longer as it needs to process the data from the different CAD package. Once that file's uploaded, you can easily open it and manipulate it using the CAD tools in Autodesk Fusion. Again, there is no design history to this part, but it does contain any bodies that were created in that file. As before, you can capture that design history if you need to. We can also upload an assembly file. So to do that, go to select your files and select a SolidWorks assembly file, which is the file extension SLDASM. Now, if we click open on this, it comes up with this error here. So it says, please select required reference parts and sub-assemblies. This is because the SolidWorks assembly file on its own does not contain that reference data. So you also need to select the files that that assembly is referencing to. So you can select those and click open, and there's no longer an error, and you can click upload. If you have an assembly of assemblies in SolidWorks, you'll need to pick the top level assembly and select those sub-assemblies in order to upload the whole thing into Fusion. Note that the file names need to remain the same as they were when the assembly file was created from the other CAD package. if you change any names in your File Explorer, you may experience errors whilst uploading the file. Once the file has uploaded, you'll be able to open that assembly and manipulate it within Autodesk Fusion to make any changes that are required. You'll see here that it contains the full assembly structure with the top level component and each of these components making up that assembly here. When we import assembly files, either from SolidWorks or Inventor, the components no longer have the joints associated with them, so you would need to add in those joints from the menu in Fusion. However, as all of the components are already in place, what you can use is an as-built joint. Check out the video here on using as-built joints if you want some more help on how to do that. This is because all of our components are already located in the correct position, and we just need to create the joints where they exist. Again, you can turn on that design history if you want to make any changes that will be captured down the line. This is a great way of interacting with co-workers who are working in different CAD packages when you want to collaborate on projects together. So now we've learned how to import different file types into Autodesk Fusion for using in our designs. What I'm going to show you now is how we export file types such that we can share them with others who may not be in our Fusion Hub or team. In order to export a file, you go to the file symbol up here and go to export. Now this here was the assembly file with a link component. So our option for our native Fusion export here is an Autodesk Fusion archive file, which is a .f3z. We can select the location that we'd like to save this to. So we can save this to file formats. I'll just change the name there to version 2. And you can click save and then export. We then get a job status here and the export has started notification. Once an export is completed, we'll then get a notification to say that it is finished. Once the export is complete, that notification pops up in the top right, and you can open the file location using the link here. You note here with that linked component, we had the F3Z file. If I break this link such that all data is contained within this one file, and we go back to that export option, you'll see here that the F3Z file has changed to an Autodesk Fusion archive file, .f3d. Now both archive files contain all of the information, but in this case, as there's no linked components, we just have that one F3D file. Again, you can save it to the location that you wish to do so. We can also choose a whole host of different file formats that are available to us, some of which we've covered in this video, that OBJ file and the STEP file, and we can also export as other file types like the Autodesk Inventor file type. Those mesh file types can also be generated in a different way. Check out this separate video on exporting file types for 3D printing and making, such as STL, mesh files, and DXF files. So that's just a few different ways that you can export files from Autodesk Fusion. I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it interesting and learned how to work with different file types inside Autodesk Fusion. If you've got any questions, please do post them in the comments below or on the Autodesk forum pages. If you've liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and I'll see you in the next one.